Good morning. I want to try this out. This is if I would use the stepping stool. This is awesome. Welcome to chapel, an exciting day, as we have our very first of this year class-led chapel service. So we are so thankful for the work of our third graders who have put forth time and effort to prepare this entire service, all the content, including songs and message, to rehearse it and practice and be ready to bring God's word to us today, to be reminded of God's promises, to be strengthened in faith, and for those in this room and for those who choose to watch on our live stream outside of this room, what a gift it is to share God's word with the world. So I want to just pray for our third grade class and for our time together, and then I'll turn it over to today's chapel leaders. Let's pray. Dear God, Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful day, but especially for the gift it is to be in this place, to be wherever we are and hear your word. We thank you for the gift of our third graders, for their leadership and for this time. Be with them as they lead us in your word, but also open up their hearts so they can hear it, that we would all in this place and gathered around receive your word and be strengthened in the gift of faith you've given your people and the promises that we walk in as we follow you with joy. This we pray in Jesus' name, and all God's people said, Amen. Amen. Okay, third grade, take it away.
Welcome to chapel. We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. There is one body and one Spirit. One Lord, one faith, one baptism.
One God and Father of all.
As Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father,
even so we also should walk in the newness of life.
Please stand as we say Luther's morning prayer. I thank you, my Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have kept me this night from all harm and danger. And I pray that you will keep me this day also from sin and every evil, that all my doings in life may please you. For into your hands I commend myself, my body and soul and all things. Let your holy angel be with me, that the evil foe may have no power over me. Amen.
Please read Exodus 6, verse 1 with me. Then the Lord said to Moses, "Now you shall see what I do to Pharaoh. Because of my mighty hand, he will let them go. Because of my mighty hand, he will drive them out of his country."
Please be seated. We will now sing "I Love to Tell This Story."
Thank you.
The Israelites had lived in Egypt for many years at the time of Moses. The Israelites were living in slavery.
The craziest thing just happened to me. God spoke to me out of a burning bush in the desert. He wants me to go to Pharaoh and ask him to let the Israelites go.
Why would Pharaoh agree to that?
Yeah, I wasn't so either, but God gave me some miraculous signs to show Pharaoh. I will do what God has commanded. He wants you to come with me, will you?
Of course.
Pharaoh, our God, wants us Israelites to go into the desert to worship him.
What? Who is this Lord? We shall listen to him. We met with our God. He wants us to offer sacrifices to him.
Don't be silly. You're rejecting everyone from their work. Go away.
Slave driver,
don't give the Israelites any more straw for making bricks.
How will they get straw then?
They will have to get it themselves.
So should they make fewer bricks?
No, they still have to make the same amount of bricks.
Okay, I'll tell them. They have to work very hard.
The Israelites began working very hard, but were not able to make enough bricks.
We are working very hard.
We are so tired.
We can't make enough bricks.
Yes, because we also have to gather the straw.
Moses, this is all your fault.
Pharaoh thinks we are lazy because you asked him if we could go worship God in the desert.
God has told me to talk to Pharaoh again. Aaron will speak for me because I am a clumsy speaker.
Pharaoh, you must let us go worship God in the desert.
Show me a miracle. Show me that your God is real.
Then Aaron threw his staff down, and it became a serpent.
This is ridiculous. I still will not listen to you, Moses.
The next day, Moses and Aaron met Pharaoh next to the Nile River.
The God of Israelites wants us to go worship him in the desert. So this is what the Lord says. I will show you that I am the Lord.
Look, I will strike the water of the Nile with a staff in my hand, and the river will turn to blood. The fish in it will die, and the river will stink. The Egyptians will not be able to drink any water from the Nile.
Aaron raised his staff and struck the water of the Nile. Suddenly, the whole river turned to blood.
I still won't listen to you or your God.
But the Pharaoh was not able to turn the river back into water.
The Lord will send more plagues on Egypt because you will not listen.
The Lord sent plagues of frogs and gnats and flies and sicknesses on the livestock.
All my cattle and goats have a deadly plague.
And boils.
Ouch, my skin hurts from these boils.
And hail.
I have never seen such a bad storm. Even the trees have been destroyed.
And locusts.
All my crops have been eaten by locusts.
And darkness.
I can't see anything. Won't you let us go, Pharaoh?
No!
Moses obeyed God, even though the Israelites complained, and Pharaoh kept saying no. Moses prayed again and again for God's guidance. Let's fast forward 3,000 years. Who are you most like in the story? Are you like Pharaoh?
I stubbornly did whatever I wanted. I did not want to obey God.
Or the Israelites?
We complained and blamed others for our pain and struggles.
We didn't trust God's plan.
Or Moses?
I trusted God's plan and obeyed him.
How do you react when your schoolwork is done poorly?
Whatever. Why should I care? Why does it matter?
I didn't have enough time. I had to go to my sister's basketball practice last night.
God, help me be responsible so that I can glorify you through my schoolwork.
How do you react when you lose a game?
We actually won. Nerf made bad call.
We lost because the teams weren't fair. It's not fair!
We lost because the other team was better than us. God, please help us practice hard.
How do you react when someone hurts you?
You're mean. I won't forgive you unless you apologize.
I'm worthless. No one loves me.
I am a child of God, loved and saved by Jesus Christ.
God saved the Israelites from slavery, and Jesus rescued us from sin, just like Moses. We can trust God to help us do the right thing in every situation. Therefore, my dear brothers, stand firm. Let nothing move you. Always leave yourself nearly to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 58.
Please bring offerings forward as we sing, I Will Follow.
Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow. Who you love, I love. How you serve, I serve. This
Please stand and pray with me. Dear God, be with those who are going through hard times. Provide for those who are homeless and hungry. Lord, in your mercy. Heal those who are sick and those who are recovering from surgery. Be with the doctors and the nurses as they serve others. Lord, in your mercy. Guide the leaders of St. John and our nation. Protect us and lead us the ways in your ways. Lord, in your mercy. Thank you for the teachers, pastors, friends, and parents. Help us love each other like you loved us. Lord, in your mercy.
Please join me in saying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, and forgive us our sins who trespass against us. And come to temptation, deliver us from evil, and ask the kingdom, power, and glory, forever and ever. Amen.
We will now sing Amen.
Mind if I borrow that mic? You've been talking about it. Everybody got a story. Well, here is mine. I was so lost. I was so lost, but now I'm found. Yeah. Hey, hey, preacher man, let's take a walk down by the river. Let the holy water wash over me. 'Cause now that I've been delivered, I want the whole world to know that I'm a new man. I'm standing here today. If you're feeling what I'm feeling, let me hear you say, amen. If you're a new creation, amen. If you got that fear root in your soul, that hope that won't let go. If you're feeling what I'm feeling, let me hear you say, amen. Every time I look back over my shoulder, I can see the life he saved me from. Every time I look back over my shoulder, I can see the life he saved me from. Thank God. Church, now you see this little light of mine. Well, my question is a simple one.
Who's next?
Come get in line. I'm talking one by one by one. I'm gonna testify that it's only by God's grace we're standing here today. If you're feeling what I'm feeling, let me hear you say, amen. If you're a new creation, amen. If you got that feel good in your soul. Every time I look back over my shoulder, I can see the life he saved me from. Thank God.
You may be seated. The Lord bless us and keep us. The Lord make his face shine on us and be gracious to us. The Lord lift up his countenance on us and give us peace. Amen.
Wow, guys, what a fantastic job you did this morning. Let's give God the glory for what you did, for what you shared. I know you worked really hard on that, and I'm just excited to hear the way that you share your faith. You did a fantastic job. You were loud enough. You spoke clearly. We could hear what you were saying. You shared that story of Moses in kind of a new way with us. It is our last Wednesday of the month of November. That's crazy. Next week we won't be together on Wednesday because we have Thanksgiving break. So we have a lot to take care of today. A whole lot to take care of today. We're going to start with our baptismal birthdays for the month of November. And then we have a whole bunch of other things to give out too. So I've asked Mr. Rodeman if he would help me with this because I only have two hands. And I don't speak very well. It's kind of like Moses and Aaron, you know? So, November baptisms, we have Amara Basso. We have Carson Bruss. Is that Bruss or Bruce? Bruss. We have Kenzie DeVries. We have Charlotte Grande. We have Ethan Hackman, Addison Hall, Amelia Hall, Will Hively, a whole mess of O'Briens, Eli O'Brien, Maya O'Brien, and Zoe O'Brien. Landon Peterson. Matthew Rimke. Owen Ripple. No Owen today. No Samuel Rozek today. Eva Schlamer. No Eva today. Lydia Singh, Cole Stork, Naomi Strasberg, and Madeline York. All of you baptized in November. In this birthday, this baptismal birthday is a really important thing. It's the new life that Christ gave in you through your baptism. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, what a gift it is to have these students here at St. John's. What an awesome opportunity to get together every day and to share the love that you have for them with each other. Lord, we thank you for the gift of baptism, the gift of new life, the gift of a new start and forgiveness every single day. And we pray, Lord, that you would keep each of these kids in your baptismal grace as they continue to grow until that day when you call them home. And we pray all in Jesus' name. Amen. You can return to your seats. Thank you. 20 of them. November was a good month, evidently. Now, end of the month, we have the Joy Awards to pass out. And then a whole bunch of other things. Look how thick this thing is this morning. It's crazy, because it's also the end of the quarter. So, Joy Awards. Is it Mila or Mila? Mila Herbelsheimer. I'm going to get all these names someday. I just have a hard time because I can't see faces. Sutton Conway. Aria Becker, I don't think she is here today. Amelia Merkel. Aria Kelm, now she is here. Fantastic. Liam Kelly. Zoe O'Brien. Elias Rodiman. Do you know him? Charlotte Grande. Ethan Hackman. Is there something about being baptized in this month that also makes you especially put Jesus, others, and yourself in that order in this month? Hayden Dunn. He's got a long walk. And that is actually it, because we have Aria. I want to, as Hayden makes his way down here, I want to say a special thank you to each of you just for the way that you are seen by your teachers and your peers, putting Jesus first in your life, which means putting yourself later on, putting others second in your life, which means putting yourself later on. There is no better way that you can share Jesus with those around you than the way you act, and we appreciate the example that you give each other, and you give to us, too, as you live your faith. Let's give them a round of applause and praise God for them. You can head back to your seats. And I am now going to ask for some help here from some of your teachers. Oh, let's see. Who do we go with first? We have some PE awards. Let's start with Mr. Young. Can you come forward and present some awards? And we'll have Mrs. Riley follow him. So if she wants to start making her way up. Or you can use a, you might have to turn it on, actually, I'm not sure. Ooh, there you go.
Hey, good morning, guys. Each year, actually each quarter, we do a physical education award, or PE award, for those that show sportsmanship, effort, and abide by our core covenants in gym class. So we have three middle school students, starting with our sixth grader, who's going to be back up here, Charlotte Grande.
Charlotte's going to need a Sherpa to bring all of her awards home.
Our seventh grader this year that had the Got the Core Covenants Award is Maddie Hesse. And our eighth grader is Mackenzie Holte.
And for my students, I have Jackson Beekler, Gabby Ferris, Miles Bennett, Emily Mortensen, Paige Rubeck, Luke Heisdorf.
I know.
But you should still know it was him, right? Or else you'll wonder who I chose. Zoe O'Brien and Amelia Mortensen.
Yep, we're going to send you all back. Thank you.
And also for the first quarter, celebrating the Eagles Music Award for effort, attitude, and hard work in music classes in the first quarter, Cole Stork, Tessa Kelly, Miles Bennett, Isla Bola, Amelia Merkel. Sophia Remke. Jackson Klaff. Dana Kircher. Nora DeVries. Isabel Marquardt. And Mackenzie Holte. Congratulations.
You all can head back. Thank you so much for showing leadership. It's great to celebrate leadership. It's fun to see people step up and take leadership in various ways through the talents that God's given them, whether that's through music, through the gift of athletic ability, through the gift of academics. And I am going to continue the theme of having teachers help me with this. Ms. Schultz, would you come forward? Ms. Schultz will present Honor Roll. Wow. Ms. Schultz will present Honor Roll to our sixth grade students. These are students who had an A average during that first quarter this year. And you probably needed a microphone for this.
I mean, I could be loud.
You could be, but that's all right.
Kingston Beekler, he's not with us today, but we're still going to recognize him. Nora DeVries. Calvin Dunn. While these guys are walking up here, I just want to add one thing. When you guys get to middle school, we actually make our grading scale or percentages of what you guys get a little bit harder. Did you know that? Well, our middle schoolers know it, and they've had to work really hard to adjust. Chuck, I need you to help me with this one. Kaylee Gunville. Guys, look, it's Kaylee. Matthew Merkel. Kaylee, that's incredible. Great job. Celia Mila. Jackson Oliver. Grant Rasmussen. Aaron Terp. And that's all that we have for sixth grade.
Fantastic. If we keep this up, we'll fill up the entire front because so many people did so well. So we're going to let sixth grade head back, and we'll have Mrs. Frazee come up and share seventh grade.
Recognizing our seventh graders, Olivia Friedemann. Olivia Krell. Emery Miller. Samantha Peterson. And Jacob Terp.
Thank you, Mrs. Frazee. Thank you, seventh grade, for your hard work. You can return. While Mr. Young makes his way forward. Thank you, ma'am. And he's got a friend with him, it looks like. Do you want me to hang out with your friend? We'll do that.
All right, for eighth grade honor roll, we have Vincent Davies. Hayden Dunn. Kaden Friedemann. Ben Hesse. Mackenzie Holte. Allison Gunville.
Ooh, I'm so excited.
Yeah, Allison. Easton Oliver. And Avery Uber Zetzig, who is not here today. Your eighth grade honor roll students.
Thank you, eighth grade. You can all head back to your seats. That's a lot of people, isn't it? A lot of people have done a lot of great things here that we can celebrate. There are just a couple of more people. Now I have hardly anything left in here. But there are just a couple left, as long as I don't fall down on my face. These two people did something extra special. We already heard how it's more difficult when you get into middle school. That means getting all A's is even more difficult than it would be otherwise. And there are two students who achieved all A's in the first quarter this year. So if I can have Joshua Brusky come forward. And Madeline Hesse, come forward. This is a pretty big deal, and I'm guessing that it might have taken a little bit of hard work on your part. You don't think it was a little? Was it a lot of hard work on your part? Whatever. Praise God for the talents and the gifts that He's given you and the fact that you use them to the best of your ability. Thank you for being leaders here at St. John's. Let's give them a round of applause. And you can go back because it's probably awkward to be up here. And that is it. What a fantastic opportunity. Next week, I pray that you have a very, very blessed Thanksgiving celebration. May God bless your day. Go learn something.